Hi, I'm George Pearson, and we're going to make a Minecraft resource pack. Once you have that done, you'll then be able to edit and create graphics to put inside of Minecraft. Okay, let's get to it. All right, let's take a look at making a custom resource pack for Minecraft. And the first thing you need to do is to make a folder on your hard drive. Have one right here. It's just in my Minecraft folder right there. I'm calling it Minecraft Resource Pack. This is just where we'll be storing the files as we're working on setting up the custom resource pack. Okay, once you have a blank folder or empty folder set up, click on play. Now, this is being demonstrated for the Java version of Minecraft, one that you play on Windows computers specifically. And there's the installer starting. We'll just go ahead and load in Minecraft. And there we go. Now the first thing you want to do here is to click on Options and then click on Resource Packs. This is just like if you're going to be installing a resource pack. Click on Open Resource Pack Folder. At this point though, one change. Here of course is where you'd be placing your finished resource pack right inside here. But up here where it says Resource Packs, back up one step where it says .minecraft. Click on that, and this takes you into all of the files that run Minecraft. Come down in the folders down here to where it says versions and open this up, and in here come down and find the version that you're using right there. This is currently 1.14.3. You can see that we have 0.4 is coming up pretty soon down here, but we're on 0.3 at the moment. Just double click on that. Inside there you'll see two files, a jar file and a JSON file. You want to copy the jar file over to your new folder. Let me bring that up and we'll make that copy. There we go, there's the new folder right here, and then here's one we just opened up. So select the jar file and then using the right mouse button just drag that over and copy here. There you go. Okay, go ahead and I can close that down for the moment. So there is our jar file. Now this is simply a compressed folder, kind of like a zip file. But we need to have a utility to uncompress this to extract the files out of this jar file. And for that, I like to use a program called 7-Zip. It's free, which makes it real nice. Let me bring up the website for that. You can see where you can get that 7-Zip program. And there it is. It's at 7-zip.org. And I also put a link, I copied this link over onto the download page for these Minecraft videos, and you'll find a link for that in the description. Just go ahead and download this. There's two versions, 32-bit or 64-bit. Get the one that matches your computer. Download that and install that, then you're all set to go. And again, this is free, which is the best feature, I think. Okay, once you have that installed, we can click on the jar file, right-click, and there's 7-Zip, and I'm going to extract files. This will put them into a folder that has the same name. It's right there. You can see that. Just go ahead and choose OK. It's now going to extract all that stuff. See, there's the new folder right there. And it's extracting all the files that are stored inside of this jar file. Once this is done, we're going to pull out just the piece that we need. Okay, there we go. So here's our contents. Double click on that folder and you're inside of this folder. In here, again, all kinds of stuff, and you can ignore all of that. All you want is that folder right there. Now you can just drag it up here or just right click, and we're going to be copying this. So I'll do right click copy. Let's go back to our resource packs folder, right click and paste, and give it a chance to copy that over. The reason I'm copying it and not dragging it is just in case something goes wrong, the original is still sitting there. I haven't tried to move it. So this should make it nice and easy. As soon as this is done, we can then get rid of that folder and that jar file. Those are no longer needed. All we care about is that assets right down there. Okay, we'll go ahead and let this thing finish up, and then we'll take a look at the assets and see where everything is hiding. That's actually where all of your graphics are. There we go. Okay, now click on this top one. This is your top folder. We can delete that. Right click and delete. There it goes. And get rid of that jar file. Delete. There we go. Okay, look inside the assets, and then inside of Minecraft, and right here, there's your textures right there. Open that one up. There's your textures for your blocks. There are real small images in here. Let's just back up a little bit. There's our textures again. Here's your paintings. They're all right inside of here. They're pretty high resolution, and they're just displayed at the appropriate resolution for the version of Minecraft that you're working in. Okay, so let's go ahead and back out to the assets again and to our resource pack. So that's the first part. We need three things in here. That's part one. And again, that's where all of your graphics are. So that will then allow us to do that editing and making our own look and feel for Minecraft. The second thing you need in here is a special file. Let me just bring that up over here. Now, I have this as a download. You can download this right from the materials support page. And again, the link for that is in the description if you want to, or you can just make this. You can actually make this using a text editor like Windows Notepad. Let me open this one up. I'll right-click on this, and let's do an open with. And Notepad. There we go. All this is just this little bit of text right there. Not a whole lot to it. It just tells Minecraft what it is that this whole thing is about. And then this is a pack, and it also gives them the number right here. The current number for the pack is 4, and that's as good as of version 1.13 and up. This is the correct one. You can also rename it if you want to. Normally it just says my resource pack. You can change what it says here if you want to. There's no real reason to, though, but you can go ahead and customize that if you feel like it. But that's all there is in here. Now, one thing about this, even though I opened this up in Notepad, notice that it doesn't have the .txt extension on this. So it's pack.mcmeta, M-E-T-A. I double-click, it should open back up again. So if you are saving this, just go to File, Save As, and then give it the name without the .txt. It's going to say something like this if you're just making this code yourself. It'll have the .txt on there. There it is. Just delete that. So it just says pack.mcmeta and then save. Of course, the easier way is just to download that from my site, and you're all set to go. The next thing you need is an image. And as you can see right there, it's at 128 by 128, and it's a PNG file. This is just the icon that shows up inside of Minecraft. Okay, so I have those two images, or those two files, rather. I'll drag those over here. There we go. Close that down. And that's all that you need to make your new resource pack. You see right here, there is that icon I have over here on my cat3.zip. So there it is. That's all you need at this point. Now, compress this back into some kind of a zip file. And again, we'll use that 7-zip to do that. Click on the top one, Control key, and click on your next two. So they're all three selected. Right-click on that, and then where it says 7-zip up there, let's see if I can get that. So it doesn't drop off. There we go. You want to add that to Archive right there. Don't do anything else down here. Just add it right here. It says Add to Archive. And then give this a name. I'll call this one cat4. I'm just numbering mine right now. Cat4. Choose OK. It's then going to put those into a zip folder that's named cat4. There's the temp folder for that. And it goes again pretty quickly to do this. And there we go. There's the cat4 zip. And that is what you need to install over here in your resource pack. Now, of course, I'm kind of assuming that we've already done our graphics work in here. We'll take a look at that, though, in the next video, and I'll show you how you do that. But first, let's go ahead and get this one installed. So we're back in Minecraft right now. Click on Open Resource Pack Folder. There it is again. And then just take this and copy it over here. I'm going to right-click and drag it over and copy. There it is, the cat4 right there. Okay, let's close that down. Close that down. I need to close this down. And let's go back to Options again. And there it is. It's now showing up over here inside of the available resource packs. Then to install it, let's just uninstall that one, and we'll install this. It's now installed over here in my selected resource packs. Click on Done. It will then relaunch with that resource pack. click done again, and then go in and play your game. And that's all there is to it, to creating the custom Minecraft resource pack. Now, once that resource pack is made, once you have the assets folder all set to go, you then can work on the graphics, and I'll show you how to do that in the next video. Okay, if you enjoyed this video, make sure you hit that like button and, of course, share. Don't forget to subscribe. And if you want to learn more about graphics programs, I have lots of videos on using different graphics programs, mostly on Photoshop Elements and Photoshop, but I also talk about GIMP a little bit, and I talk about CorelDRAW and some other stuff. Take a look at my channel. You'll find a lot more videos on that channel.